after 240 years of patriotic service delivering the mail, how can one person screw this up in just a few weeks? Now, I understand you bring private sector expertise. I guess we couldn't find a government worker who could screw it up this fast. It would take them a while. The president is running this post office like a business, like he said. He's running it into the ground, as he has declared bankruptcy a few times on his own businesses. In an effort to apply the facts, the real facts, not the alternative facts, based on what you have actually done, one can only reach, as a fact finder, we can only reach two conclusions. One, either through gross incompetence, you have ended the 240-year history of delivering the mail reliably on time, or the second conclusion that we could gather is that you're doing this on purpose and that you're deliberately dismantling this once proud tradition.
The gentleman's time has expired. The gentleman may answer his question.
My last question is this.
Thank you.
What the heck are you doing? What the heck are you doing?
The gentleman's time has expired.
Thank you, sir.
Will you put the machine back?
I'm very proud to lead the organization. The rest of your accusations are actually
Will you put the high-speed machines back?
No, I will not.
You will not?
Will not.
You will not. Well, there you go.
Representative Stephen Lynch. Wow, I love the Boston accent there. Again, Lynch, moderate Democrat. We're progressives here. We're not fans of that. He's facing a primary challenge on September 1st, so to go check that out too. But I mean, I'm praising him in this video, so maybe that's not the best context to bring that up in. But yeah, that was great questioning, even though it wasn't even that. It was grandstanding, fine. But I like some grandstanding if it seems authentic. And the fact that he wove in the history of the Postal Service and kind of praised public employees there, basically saying they couldn't have screwed it up as badly as he could, while needling the corrupt elements of how DeJoy got this job through the private sector and through his private donations to the Trump campaign. It really was just excellent. DeJoy is, by the way, as I just mentioned, a major Trump campaign and Republican donor, and that's expressly why he has this job. And now he will do whatever Trump tells him to do, which is basically dismantle all of the necessary elements in the Postal Service to ensure that voting by mail is done effectively. And that is the whole purpose of it. Trump admitted it as such, and he continues to do it even as Democrats try to scream at him and address this issue. By the way, though, the dismantling of the Postal Service is not popular amongst Republicans either. So Republicans and Trump need to figure this out because it's quickly spiraling out of control for them in terms of the messaging. A Republican Party and Trump campaign mega donor, Mr. DeJoy, is one of just five postmasters general to come to the post from the private sector since 1971, when the post office ceased to be a cabinet department and was recognized as the Postal Service, an independent federal agency. Mr. DeJoy has long been a major financial supporter of the Republican Party. Before becoming Postmaster General, he was the Deputy National Fundraising Chairman for the GOP. He has hosted events and fundraisers for Republican presidential candidates and presidents since 2006. Since 2016, Mr. DeJoy has donated $1.2 million to President Trump's campaign coffers and nearly $1.3 million to the Republican Party. Over the years, his businesses have been the subject of complaints of sexual harassment and unsafe working conditions. Mr. DeJoy has also been cited by the National Labor Relations Board for acting with anti-union animus. A 1997 decision by the U.S. Court of Appeals for the Ninth Circuit affirmed that the company had violated labor laws, his company, by deliberately avoiding rehiring unionized employees who worked at a U.S. Army terminal where New Breed had secured a contract. Sounds like a mini Trump there, right? And you know how Trump in 2016 bragged about how he basically paid off the different Democrats and Republicans that he donated to and how that was the purpose of it and how he said he was self-funded, which wasn't true, but he claimed to be self-funded and that he would drain the swamp because he knew how the system worked and that he was the one who did all the buying. Now, that never materialized, but this is one of the guys who was the buyer. One of the buyers. And then he appointed him to head the post office and postal service and dismantle it entirely. I mean, it just goes to show how insanely hypocritical he is, how little ideology he has. And a reminder, though, that Democrats have also flirted with privatizing the Postal Service. So this is something we're going to have to pay attention to, even if Trump loses. There's always a push to privatize from corporate Democrats and from the right. And the only difference here is that Trump's doing it expressly for the purpose of suppressing the vote and maybe attempting to lay the groundwork for stealing the election.